Are you wondering if an air-to-water heat pump is right for you? Or are you just curious whether prices and the technology have gone for air-to-water heat pumps? This video consists of three parts, aiming at providing all you need to know about this clean heating and cooling alternative. First, what I wish I had known before switching from gas to electric. Second, facts that matter. And third, frequently asked questions. Air-to-water heat pumps can deliver 90% less emissions, use 80% less energy, and save 40% on your energy bill compared to a standard gas and water heater. An air-to-water heat pump system can be installed within a day. They provide you with heating, cooling, and hot water. To learn if it's worth it for you and what to consider, make sure to watch to the end of the video and please subscribe. If designed and installed properly, air-to-water heat pumps save money long-term in most cases because of their higher efficiencies and lower utility costs. They're typically associated with higher upfront costs, so you may consider financing options as well. Most homeowners see a range of $3,000 to $9,000 to install an air-to-water heat pump. The price depends on the equipment you choose, your geographic location, how well your home is insulated, and the size of your property. The amount of money you'll save on your utility bill depends on the type of heating and cooling system you currently have, as well as the fuel that it uses. Most US homes are heated with a furnace or boiler system that uses gas, oil, or propane to operate.
We had a gas heating system. It looks like we're paying about 40% less than we used to pay, and that's really gratifying for me. I think it's a substantial saving, and the longer I live, the more I'll save. I'm really happy about that.
If you have an older central air conditioning system that needs replacing, now might be a good time investing in your air-to-water heat pump options. If you have existing ductwork at your property for the air conditioner, it's worth considering a ducted system, as you can likely use the existing ductwork. Before we dive into facts that matter, please hit the subscribe button and bell below the video. You can help this channel to hit 1,000 followers and help other people to decide if an air-to-water heat pump is right for them. Air-to-water heat pumps are the most efficient heating technology, 3 to 5 times more efficient than gas water heaters. But how can such a seemingly simple technology deliver 90% less emissions, use 80% less energy, and save 40% on your utility bill compared to standard gas and water heaters? In principle, the answer is simple. They move heat rather than burning fuel. As you might know, heat pumps in general use electricity to move heat, functioning like a refrigerator in the summer and in reverse in the winter. They collect, concentrate, and move heat from the air around them into water in the tank. In addition to tankless air source heat pumps, air-to-water heat pumps use tanks to store energy. An air-to-water heat pump uses the same concept as an air-to-air heat pump for extracting low-temperature heat from the outdoor air. The difference is that it delivers heat at useful temperatures into a stream of water rather than air, passing through a condenser. A water tank stores heated water, which delivers both heating and hot water whenever you need it, and it replenishes to make sure you never run out. No need for an expensive battery. And if that isn't enough, air-to-water heat pumps have a less well-known added benefit. They can double as clean energy batteries by essentially storing emissions-free solar energy to use during times when the sun isn't shining. The water tank of an air-to-water heat pump can be used as a thermal battery to store renewable energy, for instance, when solar energy is abundant in the middle of the day, and avoid using electricity in the evening when it is most likely to be generated by the district power plants. With good tank insulation, it is possible for the water in the storage tank to stay hot enough for at least a day or two, or even longer, with well-insulated pipes and fittings. Geothermal heat pumps are still more efficient than air-to-water heat pumps. But while the COP advantage of geothermal heat pumps generally remains true, the COP gap has been steadily closing due to refinements in cold climate air-to-water heat pump technology. You shouldn't have to worry about when to use electricity. If you'd like to take advantage of time-of-use rate plans that are increasingly rolling out across the country, or if you want the cleanest heating and cooling system possible, choose a smart air-to-water heat pump system that can shift the load. The duct curve is a graph of power production over the course of a day that shows the timing imbalance between peak demand and energy production. The duct curve is a phenomenon that has become increasingly important as more solar power has come online. Solar generates the most electricity midday when the sun is most intense. Without any form of energy storage, after times of high solar generation, generating companies must rapidly increase other forms of power generation around the time of sunset to compensate for the loss of solar generation, a major concern for grid operators where there is rapid growth of photovoltaics. Load-shifting air-to-water heat pumps are the solution to that. They run while electricity supply is high at midday, and the water tank serves as a thermal battery providing heating and cooling when needed. One of the most frequently asked questions is if air-to-water or any heat pump system works in cold climates. The short answer is yes. Heat pumps work in extremely cold temperatures. In the past, some heat pumps worked better in frigid climates than others. Thanks to technological advances, most heat pumps on the market today can keep you and your family warm on even the coldest of winter days. Installing a heat pump is one of the most financially sound decisions a homeowner or business can make. Even though the vast majority of heat pump installations achieve a far payback period, the life expectancy is 25 years. Out-of-the-box solutions, even with experienced installations, don't often reach their maximum potential. To maximize your heat pump's efficiency, make sure you get the system planned for your specific demands and that the system is tailored to suit these. Even non-customizable systems that are installed properly can see an increase in efficiency that translates into thousands of dollars in savings over the installation's lifetime. Find an installer that is experienced with various types of projects. This should increase your chances that the installation plan isn't off the shelf. Make sure that they use an engineer to conduct a thorough inspection of the building as well as your current and future needs. If your project is a new building, you have an enormous opportunity to make many provisions for a holistic system that will make the building extremely efficient. If you have requested multiple bids from installation contractors, don't just go by the lowest offer. Be prepared to spend a little more upfront for a proper installation, and you will soon see the benefits of getting the job done right. That doesn't mean you should jump to the highest bidder. Ask them to visit the site and offer you a consultation. You'll be able to tell a lot from the way installers examine the site and the suggestions they put forward. Installing an air-to-water heat pump is a relatively simple process. An installation should begin with a proper inspection of your property. The engineer assesses your heating needs, how large the home is, the installation level within the home, how you would like to distribute the heat, etc. The installation process itself takes about a day per indoor unit on average. Most installations will follow 6 steps. Installing indoor units, creating access points inside the home, connecting outside pipes to the indoor units, installing the outdoor unit, connecting wiring and electricity, and finishing touches. One of the great advantages of heat pump systems in general is that they can both provide heating and cooling for your home. If you only need heating, the same reasoning applies as for heating and cooling. The difference is that you most likely live in an area where you need a cold climate heat pump. And the advantages of using a water tank as a thermal battery are even greater. If you only need cooling, you might still want a heat pump to cool your home. In this case, an SOS heat pump is probably your best bet. Though more commonly associated with heating in the winter, heat pumps are an excellent cooling option in the summer. In fact, an air conditioner functions like a heat pump, working only to cool your home. In humid climates, heat pumps also perform well and can keep your home comfortable all season long. Since they are so energy efficient, when relying on your heat pump all year round, you will most likely save money on your monthly utility bills. You also don't have to worry about heat waves or sudden spikes in summer temperatures. Heat pumps continue to cool efficiently, even in high heat. If you can afford the upfront cost or choose a convenient financing option, an air-to-water heat pump almost always saves you money on your overall energy bill. By using the tank as a thermal battery, the air-to-water heat pump system can run at the highest ambient temperatures, decreasing the electricity needed to make up for the difference between the temperature inside and outside the home. If you want to learn more about geothermal heating and cooling systems, I'd recommend watching this video. Feel free to take a look at my other heating and cooling videos. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video.